Hello there, I'm Cecile. Welcome to my channel. Welcome to my first video. I kind of had to do this because I have mentioned that I've been doing this, trying to get my channel started for quite a while. When I make comments, you know, something would be said and it's like, well, when I do my channel, it's going to be this, and when I do my channel, it's going to be that. And it's like, oh, okay. So somebody read one of those comments and decided to subscribe to my channel. I don't have content up yet. If this is the first, yeah. I figured I'd better actually get my rump in gear and actually do it. And as Noelle from Costuming Drama likes to say, if you want to do the thing, just do the thing. Don't wait. Just do it. Good advice, Noelle. Thank you. What am I about? Well, like it says on my channel, I am the plus size costumer. I am plus size because, I mean, I got a fairly big bust. I got the extra large biceps from all the flab. I have hips that won't quit. Yeah, they're huge. I have to be careful when I go, like when I go to the doctor's office, I have to check what kind of chairs they have there, because there are certain armchairs that I can't fit in because my hips, specifically my thighs, are too wide. So this is why I'm the plus size costumer. So what will I be doing? Primarily sewing historical costumes or historically based costumes. I don't do cosplay. I enjoy cosplay. I think cosplay is absolutely the most wonderfulest thing in the world. But it's not my thing. It's not my jam. So I'm not going to be doing that. I'll leave that to folks who are a little more talented in that way. Also, because very few cosplayers are doing characters that are disabled. Pause a moment. I have osteoarthritis in both knees, and so I have to use a cane. It's painful, but it means I can't stand for more than 2 or 3 minutes without being in pain. So I have to sit a lot. It's frustrating. I used to dance. I used to run. I used to do lots of things. I used to go hiking in the woods. Yeah, I don't do that much anymore. I used to go walking down creek beds looking for swimming holes. Can't do that anymore. So I do what I can. And I've always been sewing, so this is what I'm going to do. Sewing historical clothes, costumes, for a plus size form. There are a lot of folks out who are looking for patterns specifically for plus sizes. A lot of the commercial pattern companies out there that do historical costume patterns do allow for the larger form. Not so much the larger form, but the larger sizes. They don't exactly conform to some of the sizes that I would like them to, but then I'm a bit of an anomaly. Or maybe not. I don't know. Because of my measurements. My upper measurements I can do fine with. It's my lower measurements that end up... Well, no. No. But we'll get into that another time. When we get into doing my corset cover and my jacket for the gown I'm working on. I'm using truly Victorian patterns. And their way of doing with the bodices, I think, is a really good way of figuring the patterns and such, figuring the size of the patterns. It allows for the back to be taken care of, but then the front, because of my differences in my measurements, I have to actually size up the front patterns a bit. We'll get into that when I get into doing the actual jacket. I also make beaded jewelry. I am wearing a bracelet here. Actually, three bracelets and a Fitbit. This is all one. It's just wrapped three times around my wrist. And then these are two separate beaded ones. These are simple beading. You just put the beads on the string and, or in this case, the clear elastic, and then you tie it up. This one took a little bit of time. And I had to figure out how to join it, because the way the pattern works, there is no way to join it. You just put, are supposed to just put it into a clasp. I didn't do that. I can go into some of the beaded jewelry I do. I get a curated bead box once a month. It comes with kits for two projects. Pattern, beads, sometimes the supplies, depending on what they are, how unusual the supplies are. If it's just thread and a beading needle, no. They figure everybody's got those. But like a special beading wire or a special ear wires or clasp or something, then they'll include those. So two projects with beads and patterns, a third pattern that does not include the beads, and then a whole bunch of other beads for your stash. I'm not sure I can go ahead and say the name or not. I will check with them if they mind, because they have their own channel where they show the different projects that they have, and they have thousands of different beading projects. So I can maybe do my take on one of them. A lot of times I'm beading from somebody else's pattern. Every once in a while I'll come up with one of my own, but not very often. One of the things I will be doing, because I have need of this, I have this hat I wear to the doctor's office, and it's a lightweight straw hat. And one of the problems is that when we get in the car, and if it's a nice day, I use medical transport. Right now, we don't have a car of our own. And so with the nice day, the windows are open in the car. Next thing I know, my hat's flying off. Thank God we're inside the car and my hat's not flying out a window, or I wouldn't make the driver stop the car and go and get my hat. But yeah, so I keep saying to my fiancé, Arthur, I keep saying, honey, I need a hat pin. And then I wouldn't get one. And then I'd go again, and it's like, honey, I need a hat pin, because the hat flies off again. So I got some of the things. I got the pins and the things to put on the end. And I have some beads, and I've already got a bead together, or one sorted together, but I'm waiting for a few more components. Because I'm not supposed to do that. So when I get a couple more components, they should be coming soon. They've been shipped. I'm just waiting for that. Then I will be making a video on how to make a hat pin, so that y'all can go ahead and make your own hat pins. And then you can wear them with your lovely outfits and have a matching, coordinating, match the hat, match the outfit. It's really simple. It's one of the simplest things. It's just getting the components together. I also have a few things in the works. I can also do other accessories. I've made bags. This is my own personal, full of my stuff, purse organizer. It's got all sorts of pockets in there. It's got 8 pockets and then an open area in the middle. I make wallets. This I keep all my cards in, and cash when I have it. Who it's pretty much, who carries cash anymore? So I have that, and I keep these in my, this is what I carry when I don't want to carry my handbag or shoulder bag. Yeah. My shoulder bag can hold just about everything I own. Well, no, not quite. There's a few things. That's a couple of things I do. So, what's in the works? I have two things I'm working on right now, two garments. I'm working on my chemise to go with a natural form gown I'm going to be making. I'm also making a corset to go with my natural form gown. It's the first corset I'm making for myself. I have made one corset once before. That turned out great. That was wonderful. It was for a wedding dress for a client. I've been wanting to make a corset for myself, and wait till you see that one. There's some funny stuff in that one because of fit issues at the very beginning. So there's the corset. The chemise needs to just get the hem and the trim on the hem finished. I'm procrastinating on that one. Actually, I need help with that because my fiance can't really get down that far on the floor. And my nibbling, which... So, like I say, I need help with getting the hem right. And as soon as my nibbling and I can get together, we will be doing that. And I will be filming part of that at any rate. Not all of it. I'm almost done with my corset. All that's needed is to finish putting in the grommets and decide on whether to put or not to put the lining in it. I have the lining. I was using the lining, actually, for the mock-up. Where do you see that? So the lining was being used for the mock-up, and I used that to help repattern the actual corset. So once I get the grommets on, then it's do a final fit, then decide if I want to use that lining or just leave it as is. Put in the waist tape, and then the boning channels, and the boning, trims, and then Bob's your uncle. It'd be done. And then I can go on to the drawers. The drawers, the two petticoats, underskirt, overskirt, jacket, hat, possibly a chemisette with false sleeves for under the jacket. The jacket comes down to about there, so I'm not sure whether I want to have bare skin or not. I'm still deciding. There's a lot of things that are still in flux. And that's all going to be for the natural form era. I told you about the cavalier outfit. Oh, and then I want to do a regency gown and a men's regency attire. Either pantaloons or breeches. I'm not sure yet. I'm not sure which Arthur would prefer. He will make decisions, but it's often just like, well, whatever you want to do, he's happy. So, yeah, with the men, it's a pantaloons, shirt, the slip waistcoat, which is basically a false waistcoat underneath a regular waistcoat, and then the coat jacket, and of course a stock or cravat. I'll have to ask Zach Pinsett about that. As far as I know, he is the be-all and end-all of men's dress from that period. And then I also want to do an 18th century English dress, or maybe it's a round gown, I don't know, something along the lines of what is worn at Colonial Williamsburg. So I'll be doing the Amalia jacket with the Augusta stays underneath, and obviously chemise and petticoats, and a false rump. And that's as far as I've gotten on things on my to-do list. I've got a whiteboard over here on the wall, so as I glance over... Oh, I almost forgot. A medieval kirtle. I've wanted a kirtle for a while, and I'm not sure if I want the square neck one with the lacing up the sides, because I'm not sure if I can reach it, or if I'll just go with lacing up the middle. To do it up the sides, I'd actually need somebody to help me lace it in it. Arthur's really good at doing things once you tell him exactly what it needs to be done, but it was fun trying on my corset when I was doing the mock-up, and he's like, well, how far apart are they supposed to be? Are they supposed to be really close or what? Arthur's a really good guy. He's a computer programmer, and he's a math genius that should be in Mensa, but he's not. You get him with computer programming and different things with computers, and he is like, he'll go off and it's like, okay, no problem. Other things that are a little more practical. When I try to explain to him about something with clothing, he tries to put it in terms of physics and geometry. And he's trying to figure, okay, well, if you do this and this and this, it's like, honey, you cannot put the human body into mathematical terms. It doesn't work. Well, I say that, and now I realize that that's a lie. You can put it in mathematical terms. But not in the way he thinks. It's not simple geometry. It's complex geometry, especially when you get somebody my size. So that's where I'm at. That's where I'm going. You may see some changes around here because right now things like this pile, my sewing area is still in a state of flux because I am relegated to maybe 10 square feet in my living room. I am looking at the end of the flat screen TV. It's like less than 10 feet from me. It makes it really fun when the resident couch potato is up and has to have the TV on. And because he's going deaf, it has to be up really loud. I just thank God for noise-canceling earphones. So that's where it's at. That's what I'm doing. This is where I'm going. And then anything after I get these things done, I'm expecting the natural form gown to be going for a while. It's going to be a journey, and it's going to be a journey that I think I will enjoy. So, with that, every journey begins with the first step. So I have made my first step by actually making this video. Thank you all for watching. And if you like this video, be sure to click the like button. If you aren't subscribed here, please hit the subscribe button. And if you want to support me and support this channel, I have a Patreon account, and I will put the link to that down in the description. Thank you all for watching, and have a wonderful day. I bid you peace. Bye-bye.